If it all stopped for me tomorrow, God forbid, I will have seen more, done more, experienced more than most people if they'd lived three times over. And I have no qualifications. And let me say this, I've sat in business situations, in boardroom tables, where there's been presidents, accountants, advisors, solicitors, I mean, a bank of intelligent, highly successful people. And there's been me on the other side going, I'm just a hairdresser. But you know what? And I was intimidated totally in situations like that. But the one thing that they didn't have, and you can't be trained for, no matter what school you've been to, is they may have had, they used to use language I didn't even understand some of the words. I was like, oh, what does that mean? I didn't understand what he just said. But the one thing they didn't have was common sense. And that's all I've got, is a bit of common sense. And that is the best qualification you can have on this earth, is just seeing it the right way. And it's not a complicated thing, it's actually the most simplest thing.
Essentially, the best you can do is to inspire people to create once they know the system, once they've got the cuts, once they know about the sense of color to skin to hair. Once you've got all that, hey, you go your own way. Make it happen in your way. And we encouraged that. Some people say that we're terribly rigid, but no. Some of the great work has come from the system, which has been taken further by individuals within the group.
When my dad, and when I started hairdressing, all you could do was feed a family and drive a modest car. Nowadays, you can become a multi-millionaire. So in my lifetime, that's how much it has changed. And I'm sure it's going to change equally as much in the future. So as far as opportunities and possibilities go, endless. So there's no barriers anymore. It's not just a modest job. You can be, well, a very rich, successful person. The other thing I would say, and I relate this quite often to young people, is that it's a bit like learning to drive a car. When you learn to drive a car, you're actually learning to pass a test. You actually start to learn to drive the car the next day when you're in it on your own, going down the freeway, and there's cars coming the other way. That's when you learn to drive.
it's so essential for people to hug their principles. Just put your arms around your principles and don't let them go. Because everybody else will want you to. Take the easy way. You can't.
I was always an advocate of, this is the way I'm going to go. And I will say no to everything, because this is my belief.
I've been hairdressing now, I'm 51, 52 this year, in 2 months' time, and I was 14 when I started doing hair.
It's great to be at 73. I had a quadruple bypass in April, which just gave me a lousy 2 months. But after that, I'm swimming a mile again. I'm okay, I'm in good shape. It was one of those things that happened.
I'm not afraid to fail, because if I'm afraid to fail, I was never trying too hard in the first place.
Just because you go through school, just because you get a license, you've just passed your test. That's all you've done. I, after 37 years, am still learning my job. So it's ongoing. And the day you close your mind, the day you stop learning, the day you can't be bothered, is the day your career's flat lines. It levels right out.
You have half the fun and excitement and the joy of creativity that I've had. You're choosing a very, very fine profession. Art form, craft, call it what you like, but it's such a good one and will give you so much as an individual. Just that working one-on-one with another human being, one-on-one, will give you so much. So do it well and learn well.
You must never stop to want to be better at what you do.
I heard a wonderful joke this morning about this old guy who went to my doctor. The doctor said to him, well, how do you feel about the future? He was about 20 years older than me, and he said, I don't buy green bananas anymore. To stay alive and kicking.